Hello, and welcome to another video in our series of Microsoft Office 365 technical support modules. In this video, we show you how to troubleshoot problems connecting Outlook to Exchange Online for Office 365. This video is for global administrators of Office 365 Enterprise, Office 365 Midsize Business, and Office 365 Small Business, including Office 365 Small Business Premium. The following error may come up when users are setting up a new email account for Office 365 using the Add New Account wizard in Microsoft Outlook. An encrypted connection to your mail service is not available. This may be caused by any of the following reasons. The wrong email address was entered when adding the account in Outlook. The required updates for Outlook to automatically connect to Exchange Online aren't installed. The auto-discover CNAME record for your domain doesn't exist, or isn't set up correctly. Now I'll show you a few steps to troubleshoot the problem. The first step is to confirm that users are entering the correct email address and password when setting up Outlook and to ensure that users are assigned an Exchange Online license in Office 365. To confirm that the correct credentials are being used, users should sign in to the Microsoft Office 365 portal using the same email address and password used to set up Outlook. If users cannot sign into the portal, they might not have an Office 365 account or may need to have an administrator reset their password. When signed in, users should click Outlook from the top of the page to access the Outlook web app. Users who don't see Outlook listed at the top of the Microsoft Office 365 portal after signing in may not have an Exchange Online license assigned to them, or their mailbox may have been accidentally removed. Ensure that users who experience either of these problems have an Office 365 account and are assigned an Exchange Online license. Refer to the Microsoft Knowledge Base article URL displayed on the screen for more information about deleted user accounts. The second step to troubleshooting the problem is to run Office 365 desktop setup when using Microsoft Outlook 2010 or earlier versions. Office 365 Desktop Setup configures installed Office Desktop clients to work with Office 365 and installs the required updates. You do not need to run Office 365 Desktop Setup when using Microsoft Outlook 2013. Refer to the Microsoft Knowledge Base article URLs displayed on the screen for more information about running Office 365 Desktop Setup. If you continue to experience problems setting up Outlook, you should make sure that the auto-discover CNAME record is set up correctly. We recommend that you set up Exchange Auto-Discover when you are using Outlook to connect to Exchange Online mailboxes. Administrators can use the Domain Troubleshooting Wizard in the Microsoft Office 365 portal or Microsoft Remote Connectivity Analyzer to confirm that the records are set up correctly. First, we'll use the Domain Troubleshooting Wizard in the Microsoft Office 365 portal to check if the domain is correctly configured for Exchange Online. Sign into the Office 365 portal as an administrator. Click Domains. Select the vanity domain used for Exchange Online. Click Troubleshoot. Complete the wizard by answering a series of questions. For demonstration purposes, I'll select I changed the DNS records at my provider more than 72 hours ago. Click Next. If your Exchange Auto-Discover records are set up incorrectly, the correct DNS records are displayed on the page. Click the Learn How link to view detailed instructions for how to create DNS records for Office 365 for your DNS hosting provider. Now we'll use Microsoft Remote Connectivity Analyzer, also known as RCA for short, to check the Auto-Discover CNAME record. Go to the URL shown on the screen. Click the Office 365 tab. Click Outlook Auto-Discover and click Next from the bottom of the page. Enter all of the required information into the fields. Remove the checkmark next to Ignore Trust for SSL and add a checkmark next to the disclaimer. Enter the verification code and click Verify. Click Perform Test from the bottom of the page. If your connectivity test fails, expand each of the test steps to view additional information. Click Tell Me More About This Issue to view additional information for each failed test and how to resolve the problem. If you continue to experience problems connecting Outlook to Exchange Online for Office 365, even after following all of these troubleshooting steps, refer to the Microsoft website URLs displayed on the screen for a list of additional support options. In this video, we showed you how to troubleshoot problems connecting Outlook to Exchange Online for Office 365. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope that you found it helpful.